Hi, in this session, we'll see about the parallel cursor method in SAP ABAP. So before going into the coding part, first we'll understand theoretically how it is different from a normal where clause. So in traditional ABAP, the consultant use where clause in the nested loop. This is very common, but there's a big issue with the performance when using the where clause in the nested loop with a table with whose data like EKKO, VBAK, BKPF, etc. The problem with this method is that for the each record in the main table, system do the scanning of all the record in second table. Just have a look at here. This is traditional method. Suppose we have data of around 10,000 records in the EKKO table. Okay, so first you make a loop at the EKKO table. I have so many records here, and then we look at the second table, that is the EKPO. So what happens if you use the where clause? When you are at the first index, at the first loop in the EKKO table, the system check the matching criteria, the matching record with the where clause. Okay, and first is check for the first record. If system found a matching record, if the PO number is same here and here, it performs the required logic. Again, once that record is over, it check for the second record. Again, if it is matching, if the PO number is same, this will perform the logic which is written here and then return to the loop again. Now, even the third number, third row in the second table is not matching with the PO number. But system keep on scanning all the records, third, fourth, fifth. Okay, this means what? For the each record of the first table, system scan all the records of second table. Now this is for first record. Now let's assume the first record is over. Now the second PO number is here, 111. So logically, for the second table, the scanning should start from the row number 3. But if you are using the where clause, what happen? Again, for the second record, system start scanning from the row number 1. It checks if this is matching. If it is not matching, again it will go back to loop. Then again check for the second record. Not matching, it will go again at the loop. And that the third record is matching, then system will perform the operation. Again go to loop. Like this, for each row of the first table, system scan all the records of second table. Okay, so there is a big impact on the performance of this where clause. So to avoid this performance issue, there's a concept called parallel cursor method. Okay, so what is the difference in parallel cursor method? The first table will be same. Before loop, we have to sort the data, both EKKO and EKPO. What happened before entering the second table? Before this loop, we have to check using the read table. Using the binary search operation, first we check the index number or the purchase order number with this record. Okay, and if we found the record, then in the side tabics, we get the row number. Like this PO number is starting from which row in the second table. Now, when we come into second table, instead of where clause, we start loop using side tabics. So system directly jump to row number 1. It perform the operation, go back to loop. Now, again, it will go for the next record. It will check whether my EKKO purchase order number is matching with the EKPO purchase order number. If it is matching, it will perform the next operation. Now, as soon as those both PO logic is performed, when it comes to the third number, system check here only whether the PO number is matching or not. And here at the third number, the PO number is 11, whereas the loop is at the first item, that is 10. So in this case, system comes out from this loop. Okay, so in this way, if you use the parallel processor method, in the second table, system loops only at the matching records. Whereas in the first method, for each record of the main table, system scan all the record of second table. Okay, so that's why whenever you have a nested loop, it is preferred you go with the parallel processor method. Now we'll do the actual coding part. First, we'll create a program with normal logic, nested loop. See, if we have only 10 record, 100 record, we will not find the performance improvement. But if we have 1000 record, 5000, 10,000, then there's a big impact. Nested loop versus parallel cursor. Execute local object. Let me declare some time variable, data lv underscore, let's say start time of type timestamp 1, timestamp l, then declare one second variable like lv underscore end time of type same. That is timestamp L. Then get a runtime, that is LV underscore runtime, which will nothing but a difference of the start and end time. Okay, so here we declare the variables. Now let me select data from the EKPO table first. Select all from EKKO into table. We'll use the new web syntax here. GT underscore EKKO, let's say up to 10,000 records, up to 10,000 rows. Okay, so first I'm selecting record from the EKKO table. Then if GT underscore EKKO body is not initial, then we select the record from the second table, that is the EKPO table. Select all from EKPO into table at the rate data GT underscore EKPO for all entries in at the rate GT underscore EKKO where EBEL equal to GT underscore EKKO EBELN. Okay, so what we have done here, first we have selected 10,000 records from the EKKO, that is the purchase order header table. Then we are selecting the line term. Now before we start in the loop, get runtime, get timestamp field lv underscore start time. Now for sort the data, before time sort the data, sort gt underscore ekko and sort gt underscore ekpo. Okay, now this is normal way of coding. Loop at gt underscore ekko into data gs underscore ekko. This is my first loop. Clear the work area. Now inside this, we'll write the second loop, that is loop at gt underscore ekpo into data gs underscore ekpo where ebeln equal to gs underscore ekko ebeln. So here in the second loop, we are checking using the where clause whether the purchase order number is matching or not. Okay, I'm not writing any logic inside this loop. Okay, we'll observe the time only with the loop. Okay, so here in a normal way I use a where clause. Now after the loop, again get time is time field lv underscore end time, and my runtime will be, that is the difference of both, runtime equal to lv underscore start time minus, sorry, lv underscore, that is the end time, minus lv underscore start time. Okay, and we'll write the data and the output. Let's say lv underscore runtime second, take the end time, and third take the start time. Okay, so what I've done, I've selected 10,000 records from the EKPO table. Then for all entries, I selected the EKPO table, line items. Then I run the looping using the where clause. And before going to the loop, I read the time. After finishing the loop, I read the time, that is the end time. And I got a difference of that time in the LV underscore runtime. Okay, let me execute this. We'll see what is the time here. So we can see it is taking somewhere around 6.7 second. Okay, the time is started at the 2020 is the year, 05 is the month, 09 is the today's date. Okay, 09 hour, 10 minutes and 12 second. It is start and finish at 19 second. So difference of time is somewhere around 6.7 second if you are using the normal method. Now same coding we will do with the parallel cursor method. Okay, let me keep here as it is and create one more program with the parallel cursor method. Go to SC38, nested loop PC, that is parallel cursor method. So better will copy that program only. And we do the changes. Next right loop here underscore PC, that is parallel cursor. Okay, now in the second program we'll write the logic according to the parallel cursor method. So what it says, as I told you, before entering into the second loop, first read the second table to get the exact index of the matching record. Okay, so this code will be as it is, selecting of the EKQO and EKPO table. Now here, before going to second table, what we'll do here, read table GT underscore EKPO into data GS underscore EKPO with key EBELN equals to GS underscore EKKO EBELN binary search. Okay, because we have declared data GS underscore EKPO here using the data syntax, so we have to remove data from here. Okay, so what we are doing here, first we have make a loop at the header table. Before going into second table, first we are reading the matching record. Okay, by passing the purchase order number. Now if size of RC equal to 0, if system found any record, then in the second table, loop GT underscore EKPO into GS underscore EKPO from psi tabX. Okay, this index system will find out from this syntax using the read table. Okay, now system will start looping from the index number which is find in the previous step. Now if gs underscore ekpo eblen not equals to the header po number, then come out of the loop. Remaining code is as it is. I will explain again what I have done here. First, we have made the loop at the header table. Before reading the going into the loop of second table, first we have read the matching record by passing the PO number. If system found the records, then from that index number, we are going into the second loop. And as soon as system found any unmatched record, it will come out of the loop by using the exit syntax. This is not possible in case of our first program, because here we are using the where clause. Okay, and I explained you theoretically, if you are using the where clause, for each record of the header table, system will scan all the records of second table. Okay, now we'll observe timeline. Check, activate, same number of records, executes. So here you can see the time is 0.0089 seconds. Okay, same number of records, 10,000. Let me execute against the first one. So here you can observe time. It is taking a lot of time only for the single table. So here the time is started as 09:15:20 and it ends somewhere around 26.9 second. So normal method has taken around 6.7 second to perform that operation. Whereas if you are using the parallel cursor method for the same number of record, system is taking just 0.0089 seconds. So there is a very huge difference if you are using the parallel cursor method. So no matter how many records you have, by default make a practice of using the parallel cursor method. This is very helpful from the performance point of view. So in this way I have finished this session, that is the parallel cursor method in SAP ABAP for the nested loop. Thank you.